Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Allow me to welcome you all to the MMA Amalgamations Business Leadership Award 2019. Since today is a celebration of Indian business and leadership, to set the tone, we thought it would be quite apt to begin with a thought-provoking rendition of Vaishnava Janato, a song that epitomizes our country's ethos. So we will begin with a rendition of the song. May I request you all to kindly remain seated. Thank you. Beautiful rendition by the Nightingale herself. It's now time to request our dignitaries to please join me on the dais. I now begin by inviting Mr. A. Venkatramani, President, MMA and Managing Director, IP Rings Limited, Ms. Mallika Srinivasan, Chairman, Tractor and Farm Equipment Limited and Past President, MMA, Mr. A. Krishnamurthy, Chairman, Amalgamations Private Limited, Mr. N. Vagal, former Chairman, ICICI Bank Limited, Mr. M.M. Murugappan, Executive Chairman, Murugappa Group, and Mr. Vikram Kitloskar, President, CII, Chairman and Managing Director, Kitloskar Systems Limited. And Vice Chairman, Toyota Kitloskar Motor Private Limited, to take their place on the dais. It is also our privilege and honor to now invite our awardee, Mr. Azim Premji, Chairman, Wipro Limited, to take his place on the dais. May I request Group Captain R. Vijay Kumar, Executive Director, MMA, to please escort him on stage. Ladies and gentlemen, it is now my pleasure to call upon Mr. Venkatramani, President, Madras Management Association, and Managing Director, IP Rings Limited, to take the podium and deliver the welcome address.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's my honor and privilege to welcome you to the 19th MMA Amalgamations Business Leadership Award. Distinguished awardee, Shri Azim Premji, Chairman Wipro, Shri A. Krishnamurthy, Chairman Amalgamations, Shri M.M. Murugappan, Chairman Murugappa Group and a member of the Awards Committee, Shri N. Vagal, former Chairman ICICI Bank and one of India's most respected corporate leaders, Shri Vikram Kitloskar, President CII, and Chairman and Managing Director, Kitloskar Systems, and Vice Chairman, Toyota Kitloskar Motors, Srimati Mallika Srinivasan, Past President MMA and Chairperson TAFE, representatives from the Government of Tamil Nadu, members of the media, past presidents of MMA, committee members, distinguished invitees, friends, family, ladies and gentlemen, and to everyone watching this event live on social media, a very warm welcome to all of you. Our dignitaries on the dais have all had the opportunity to interact with Shri Premji over the course of their careers, and we look forward to hearing from them about their experiences in engaging with this luminary of corporate India. The MMA Amalgamations Business Leadership Award was instituted by late Shri A. Sivasailam, Chairman of Amalgamations, and his brother, Shri A. Krishnamurthy, the current chairman of Amalgamations, in memory of their father, Shri S. Anant Ramakrishnan. This award was instituted in 1969, and since then, 18 distinguished corporate leaders of great eminence have made the award proud by accepting this honor. Shri Anant Ramakrishnan was the founder of the Amalgamations Group. He was a visionary leader whose approach to management was ahead of its times, a leader with a great commitment to social values and nation building. Shri Premji reflects this ethos, and in him we see a shining example of a lifetime of excellence in corporate and social life. Sir, the moment we announced your name as the awardee, we were swarmed with requests to attend this function. It's a true reflection of your achievements, your inspirational life, and a thorough approval of the unanimous decisions taken by our eminent jurists. Shri Anant Ramakrishnan was also a founding member of the MMA, an institute that was founded to usher in management concepts and excellence in this part of the country when management thought was at its infancy. Today, we have over 8,000 members, large corporate houses, MSMEs, who are the backbone of our economy, academicians, professionals, and students from across the state. A wide variety of members with very different needs, and the Secretariat, under the leadership of our Executive Director, Group Captain Vijay Kumar, do great work in promoting management education across the length and breadth of Tamil Nadu, a vision that was set forth by our founders 63 years ago. Last year, MMA conducted over 750 programs and catered to almost 60,000 participants. Our flagship events, the annual convention, the students' convention, women's convention, and our MMA Leadership Awards and the Chinni Krishnan Innovation Award, attract top quality speakers, both domestic and international. The events are highly anticipated and tend to be sold out. We also have an outreach program and have 8 chapters across Tamil Nadu that's being rapidly expanded, catering to education and skilling across sectors from manufacturing, IT, pharma, and so on. In this age, when skill sets are rapidly changing, the MMA continues to cater to these ever-changing needs. We've also recently inaugurated a state-of-the-art 25,000 square foot management development center in the heart of the city. This was only made possible due to the efforts of our leadership team and our generous sponsors. Thank you very much. The MMA has also been amply recognized by the All India Management Association and has been awarded the Best Management Association for the last 10 years in a row. A tribute to the leadership provided by our past presidents, our committee members, and our vibrant secretariat. As in any organization's journey, MMA is undergoing a visioning exercise so that we continue to remain relevant in an ever-changing world and contribute to our Prime Minister's Skill India initiative. The exercise is being led by our immediate past president, Sri Ram Kumar, who's managed to rope in some other past presidents, and also Sri Ramesh Mangaleshwar from McKinsey and Sri Ram Kalyan Raman also. So thank you all for your inputs. We aim to be the best learning network for the young professional in an ever-changing world, and our range of offerings which will adopt technology will center around this theme going forward. Finally, I would like to thank the members of MMA for giving me this opportunity to be the president when this prestigious award, instituted in my grandfather, Sri Anantramakrishnan's name, is being bestowed on an inspirational leader, Sri Azim Premji. It's a moment that my family and I will cherish forever. We are so very proud to have this opportunity to honor you, sir, and look forward to hearing you deliver the 19th Anantramakrishnan Memorial Lecture. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Venkatramani. Ladies and gentlemen, MMA and Amalgamations Group have put together an audiovisual on the occasion of this special award function. So I request you all to now please place your eyes back on the screen, for that's where the action's going to be.
The first half of the 20th century were the nascent days of automobiles. S. Anantharamakrishnan, a remarkable man, passionate about automobiles, understood the impact they were going to have in our lives. And he set the wheels in motion in the automobile industry in Madras, southern India. When J., as he was fondly called, turned the ignition of the car, he also turned the fortunes of the city and country. J. set the stage for the eventual blossoming of Madras as the Detroit of the South. It gave a newly born country just the boost in self-confidence that it needed in its own engineering abilities and skills. J. negotiated the complexities and contradictions of different ideologies to compete with the rest of the world he had to adapt to new challenges that competition demanded to build enduring organizations and to give the new nascent country confidence and self-belief. He was a true nation builder. He believed in nurturing a national character based on unflinching adherence to values. He was putting South India on the business map and international consciousness, even as he was setting exacting standards in the right corporate spirit. Anantharamakrishnan was always a passionate advocate of industry and believed it would make the nation stand tall amongst its peers. To him, it was the fertile ground for nurturing skills and talent to make the nation forge ahead on its own steam and look at the world with a confident gaze.
In the spirit of the founder of our group, Sri S. Anantharamakrishnan, we are committed to offer products and services to the industry with a responsible social and environmental engagement.
There might be different perspectives, opinions, and ways of doing the same thing. But when it comes to ethics, there can be no two ways of looking at it, says his granddaughter, Mallika Srinivasan, chairman, TAFE, exemplifying the spirit that runs as a constant undercurrent in the business empire that Anantharamakrishnan and his successors created. The two decades between 1945 and 1964 were crucial years as the group companies took shape, set goals, and developed a vision for one of India's most enduring and diverse conglomerates, the Amalgamations Group. Soon, the Amalgamations Group grew manifold and created an organization that gave India a head start in automobiles and agriculture. The over 40 companies within the group today are business leaders in their areas of operations and trendsetters in developing products for markets in India and across the world. Ever a thinker ahead of the times, Jay, an unmatched people person, teamed up with a group of enlightened business leaders in 1956 to found the Madras Management Association to give a world-class forum for business leaders from this part of the country. The association showed its gratitude to this son of the soil who built a true blue-chip organization by instituting an award in his group's name. Led by A. Sivasailam, his son and successor, it instituted the MMA Amalgamations Business Leadership Award in 1969. With the legendary J.R.D. Tata as its first recipient. In his acceptance speech, J.R.D. compared Anantharamakrishnan to the legendary Jamsetji Tata from one J who gave wings to the nation and made aviation history to another J who provided the wheels to move the nation ahead. It was praise from a peerless leader of men. What was first instituted in 1969 is today a prestigious award. This award's role of honor has been graced by leaders who have built Brand India, overcoming enormous challenges in the way of a developing country. Everyone who has won the award is the epitome of all that India stands for as a nation. That ethics is the core value at the heart of every venture. MMA, now in its 63rd year, has proved to be a robust voice for this part of India. It works towards showcasing the achievements and provides a forum for leaders from the south to voice their aspirations. The highly successful business leaders in its roster have proved to be great mentors and pathbreakers for its fraternity. The MMA strives to be a living, vibrant organization, interacting with its stakeholders and taking their concerns, views, and insights on board. It mentors budding entrepreneurs through workshops, programs, and events. It proved a trendsetter when it launched its flagship event, the MMA Women Managers Convention, which focuses on issues of special interest to women executives and entrepreneurs. The MMA Amalgamations Business Leadership Award is a celebration of a lifetime of service, uncompromising ethics and integrity, and extraordinary achievements of nation builders who dedicate themselves to the greater good.
I now take great pleasure in requesting Ms. Mallika Srinivasan, Chairman TAFE Limited, to pay a tribute to Mr. Ananth Ramakrishnan and to touch upon the genesis of the award.
Mr. Azim Premji, distinguished guests, President and members of the Madras Management Association, ladies and gentlemen, a warm welcome to the 19th MMA Amalgamations Business Leadership Awards. Today, as we shed the tag of a developing nation and don the mantle of an emerging power, we remember the visionaries who spearheaded the industrial journey of our country. The nation builders who traversed uncharted, unfamiliar, unforgiving territory. They, the first generation of business leaders of modern India, faced unique challenges. Access to the wider world was limited, and they had to very nimbly circumvent colonial era challenges, its inherent biases, its restrictions, constraints, and rules of conduct. Unshackling themselves adeptly, these pioneering leaders successfully set free their innate entrepreneurial spirit and sought out the world beyond their shores for partnerships that would lead them to their goal of building an industrial and progressive India. One such visionary business leader was S. Ananth Ramakrishnan. Born into a simple middle-class agriculturalist family, he made that stupendous journey from the fields of Alwar Kurchi near Tirunelveli to the boardroom of Simpson & Company, an established British company on the wings of hard work, zeal, a personality that put honesty on a very high pedestal, and integrity that was a byword amongst his British bosses and peers. These characteristics of Jay, as he was fondly called, proved to be life transforming. When the European management of Simpsons, one of India's oldest and most prestigious groups, looked for an Indian business leader to transfer their interests to, even as the country geared up for an eventual freedom. He had earned their trust in full measure. And the British departure, as they handed over the reins of Simpsons to Jay, was perhaps amongst the earliest examples of a management buyout. The journey is all the more remarkable considering that Jay started out in a modest role in the company as a company secretary and went on to eventually lead, own, and transform the company into the Amalgamations Group, a conglomeration of companies that includes engines, tractors, auto components, auto distribution, cutting tools, and has in its fold agricultural businesses, including plantations. To Jay, a business went beyond business as usual. His way of life and his work was a reflection of all the tenets that the Indian ethos holds dear to itself. Work is a privilege to be done in the spirit of service. Wealth is a trust you guard, nurture, and grow for the benefit of all. And leadership comes with responsibility towards community, society, ecology, education, environment, and country. It was a nation builder's attitude. Today, the group that he built with such vision and passion continues to uphold and cherish these values and remains a beacon for doing business the right, sustainable way with fairness, equity, and concern for all its stakeholders. Ananth Ramakrishnan was one of the founder members of the Madras Management Association in 1956. And it is a testimony to his peers and him and his foresight that they founded an organization that went on to become the thought leader for businessmen from this part of the country. It gave a platform for business leaders to share ideas, to present their views, learn from each other, and to contribute to the nation's progress. Today, in its 64th year, and as you heard Ram mention, the MMA is the strongest management association in the country. This leadership award, instituted in the memory of Ananth Ramakrishnan by the MMA, is a tribute to one of South India's most far-sighted business leaders, More than his defining contribution in giving the automobile industry a flying start in India, more than his uncanny vision on agriculture and the importance of food security, this award is a recognition of what nation building through business leadership is all about. It is a fraternity and a family's tribute to a personality who lived a life of rare humility, rich values, and supreme faith in the potential that is innate in all human beings. The names gracing the roster and roll of honor of the MMA Business Leadership Award exemplifies the concept of trusteeship of wealth, integrity at all costs, service to the nation, creating wealth through honest efforts, and deep commitment to all the stakeholders. It is a list that speaks to the world about the journey being as important as the destination, about the means being as important as the goal. From the great J.R.D. Tata, who was the first recipient of the prestigious award, the MMA Amalgamations Award has honored a band of outstanding nationalists who have unfailingly put others before self, community and society before personal progress, greater good before self-gratification. By building on this higher ground, these business leaders passed the message unequivocally that business with integrity can flourish, is universally respected, and will always be looked up to around the world. It's a great privilege to remember such a galaxy of leaders who have shaped, led, and empowered a new India. Today, to this galaxy, we add Azim Hashim Premji. His business... His business acumen, leadership, work culture, wisdom, concern towards people, and commitment towards education illuminates the path as we progress towards our potential and destiny as a nation. Our first recipient, J.R.D. Tata, in his memorial lecture said, "No success or achievement in material terms is worthwhile unless it serves the needs or interests of the country and its people and is achieved by fair and honest means." Azim Premji exemplifies this. It is befitting indeed that he has been placed today amidst great reformers who have sought change towards a more caring world. At the core of the Indian ethos is a word, dharma, righteousness, one that defines ideal leadership, a word that is frustrating to translate, almost untranslatable. Duty, goodness, justice, law, all have something to do with it, and yet it goes beyond being chiefly concerned with doing the right thing, both in private and in public life, providing the underlying norms of society, and creating obligations for citizens and rulers alike in the larger interests of all. The best Indian leaders have rested their foundations on this principle, creating, nurturing, and building organizations that have cared for people, ecology, and sustainable business practices. In bestowing today's award on Azim Premji, we honor these principles of leadership and the unique manner in which he has combined compassion with competitiveness, integrity with the nitty-gritty, the golden touch and the common touch. Thank you, Azim, for being in our midst today. You truly are a great inspiration to all of us. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Mr. N. Bagul is a philanthropist and an ex-banker professional from India. He was appointed as chairman and managing director of the Bank of India in 1981. He is a former chairman, Industrial Credit and Investment Corporation of India, the financial institution now known as ICICI Bank. He was awarded the Padma Bhushan in the year 2010. To offer his felicitation, please welcome Mr. N. Bagul.
Premji, ladies and gentlemen, I am associated with both with Amalgamations group and with Mr. Premji by coincidence 4 decades. I knew Mr. Sivasailam when he walked into my room in Central Bank of India in 1978, and my association with Azim also is nearly 4 decades old. I recall one incident. For the last 20 years, I was closely associated with Wipro. I used to go to the boardroom every quarter. When I went to the board meeting once, I got a message that Mr. Premji wanted to see you urgently. So I was a little worried. I said, is there something, a problem? So I went to see him. He looked very worried. I asked him, what's the problem? I looked at the figures, everything seemed to be reasonably good. And what is he, what to worry about? He said, Bagul, I'm deeply worried with the fact that these elections, the school teachers are being enrolled for the purpose of election work. And schools are being hijacked. As a result, the children are losing education for nearly a month. Is it really the country should not do something about it? I mean, look at that man. He was running a big organization, and that figures don't bother him. What bothered him was the fact that the children of the country are losing education for nearly a month because of teachers being summoned and their children. Of course, we discussed this matter and we came to the conclusion nothing much can be done about it. But that was a man, the man was full of compassion. It's the whole Amalgamations group was founded on, as Malika said, the principle of ethics. Very strong value system. Today, if we really look at Amalgamations group, it stands for not only the business growth, but more importantly, it has come to represent the values in business, and that's, I think, the hallmark of the Amalgamations group. And if you really look at Azim is really the iconic of business ethics in the country. And it is but appropriate that this award is being bestowed by one iconic business house on one iconic business leader. I think both are really very important. One way of looking at it is, why should we give an award to Azim Premji? He has been the most highly decorated person in the country. He has received almost every award that is conceivable in the country. What does one more award mean to him? I think more importantly, I can tell you, he has received the highest honor that the nation confer on anybody. I am not referring to Bharat Ratna. I am referring to the fact that he has found a place in the hearts of the citizens of the country. And I think if you look around, he was conferred this Andrew Carnegie Award in the International Award. Very few international philanthropists have got that award. And to get into the hearts, if you go into the nook and corner of this country, people talk in terms of Azim Premji, not only as a wealthy person, but a person who was able to practice the art of trusteeship, which Malika was referring to, is a trusteeship which was advocated by Gandhiji. I think it's easy to talk about it. He has donated considerable portion of his wealth for the sake of the society. And so, yet I believe that this award is very appropriate. This award should be given, not so much for the sake of Azim Premji, but for the sake of sending a powerful message to the society that this society will continue to honor people like Azim Premji, because we take pressure. It is not for the sake of Azim Premji we are doing it. It is for our own sake. Because we are witnessing a society in decline. We are witnessing a society where the values have strongly declined. And then what message we can send to the society. And the corruption, I don't want to use the word political corruption, because I should not be alleged that I'm, because the once a thief entered the house of a lawyer. The lawyer was about to shout, thief, thief. Then he checked himself and said, alleged thief, alleged thief. Like that, I should say that it's alleged political corruption, not political corruption, has reached a very high level. And what is most appalling is the fact, we have reached a stage where people are justifying the political corruption. See, this is inevitable. We have to live with this. In fact, one of the meetings I attended very recently, a very noted person was saying that it is necessary to have corruption to give oil to the wheels of the economy. Without that, the most of the East Asian growth story has been founded on corruption. Why should we not do that? So, how are we going to give a message to the society that there are leaders like Azim Premji? I was associated with him right from the beginning of the Wipro as an IT industry. I have seen him build this company brick by brick, uncompromising adherence to the value systems. Not once a compromise that is being made. So that is why it gives me particular pleasure in participating in this function. I want to compliment the Amalgamation Group and Madras Management Association for conferring this award on Azim Premji. And I want to congratulate Azim Premji for this award, but more importantly, I wish him give him my best wishes for many more years of active service to the society. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Rahul. Our next speaker is a fourth generation member of the Murugappa family and the executive chairman of the Murugappa Group Corporate Advisory Board since February 2018. He is chairman of Tube Investments of India Limited, Carborundum Universal Limited, and Coromandel International Limited. To offer his felicitations, I leave the podium for Mr. M.M. Murugappan, Executive Chairman, Murugappa Group.
Mr. Krishnamurthy, Mr. Premji, Mr. Vagul, Mallika, Vikram, President of the MMA, Ram, and Executive Director, Mr. Vijay Kumar, members of Sri Anantharamakrishnan's family, members of the Madras Management Association, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. First, Mr. Premji, many congratulations on being chosen as the 19th MMA Amalgamations Business Leadership Awardee for the year 2019. To MMA and the Amalgamations Group, thank you for the honor in inviting me to be part of the jury along with Mr. Ratan Tata, Mr. Seshasai, Mrs. Arundhati Bhattacharya, and Mr. Sunil Munjal. Unfortunately, they could not be here this evening. Mr. Premji, they send you their very best wishes. The MMA Amalgamations Award in itself is amongst the most prestigious awards in our country. It has always set and maintained the highest standards of all-round achievement. The jury selection process was awfully difficult in one sense and extremely easy in another. We were well supported by the research of a 15-member team from Deloitte's. But the difficult part was we had to choose from one person amongst a galaxy of eminent individuals who have built and continue to nurture enduring institutions. Our unanimous choice was the best amongst the best, Mr. Premji. And why so? There were many criteria and very stringent criteria for the award. And clearly, amongst every one of the candidates that we talked about, Mr. Premji not just met but exceeded the criteria, and I'll distill a few of them. An exemplary track record in business across various dimensions of growth, creating consistent value, good governance, and building strong capabilities. A vision of building a global business through innovation, new ideas, and embracing new technologies. Developing a management and leadership talent to support this vision. A strong emphasis on all-round quality and service. Creating meaningful employment and building skills and a professional organizational culture. A strong contribution to a positive evolution of policy and the ability to establish the right equilibrium between business and the external environment. Exemplary personal values reflected in the ethics of business and the expression of such values fearlessly in public. Outstanding citizenship and selfless philanthropy. A true leader, Mr. Premji embodies a lot more. But what stood out was a sincerity and constancy of purpose, a great courage of conviction, and an even greater content of character. Mr. Premji, as a jury, you were our first and unanimous choice. Congratulations, sir. And now to a personal note. Beyond the links to Burma as part of our respective business lineage, I've had my most embarrassing moments and greatest learnings from Mr. Premji. I don't know whether you recollect it, sir. He called me one year, many years ago, and said to me, "I'd like to visit you." And this left me shuddered, or if not, shivering. But we did receive Mr. Premji and his team at our offices. And this didn't happen for one year. It happened year after year after year. And he was always wanting to know what more Wipro could do for us. And ever since that first meeting many years ago, I've taken a leaf from your book, sir, to diligently visit our customers across our businesses. Many congratulations once again, sir. First, for being Azim Premji, being the selfless individual, being the outstanding businessman and leader, and now the recipient of the 19th MMA Amalgamations Award. And thank you, MMA and Amalgamations, for this enriching opportunity that you have given me and this wonderful location. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, Mr. Murugappan. Mr. Vikram Kirloskar occupies the position of Chairman and Managing Director at Kirloskar Systems Limited. He is also President of the Confederation of Indian Industry. We now request Mr. Kirloskar to please come forward and offer his felicitation.
Good evening, Azim, ladies and gentlemen. This is really indeed a pleasure to be at this function. When Malika called me, I always like to come to Chennai. I always see all my friends here. But coming to honor Azim is a super privilege for me and my family. I'm representing my wife and daughter, for whom anything I do, they say, do you think Azim will like it? It's always like that. What do you think he will say? So I'm going to talk a little bit more personally on Azim. Most people know him about the IT sector, about the huge growth of the IT sector, which he's been partly responsible for. But when I started work after college, I knew him as a maker of hydraulic cylinders. And I visited his factory. I used to visit his factory to buy hydraulic cylinders and sell him machinery for manufacturing cylinders. And just like you've seen the IT industry, perhaps people don't know much about his hydraulics business. It is huge. It's an international business. And we will be expecting Azim at the XCON exhibition in Bangalore, as he comes every year on December 10th and spends a lot of time with the fantastic hydraulic products that he's made. That's how my memory of Azim Premji has started, as a person in engineering and physical manufacturing. After that, of course, there was computers and then the IT business. Everyone knows about Azim's philanthropic activity, the wonderful stuff he has done. But one thing, I have a friend called Ashutosh Varsane. He's a professor at Brown who works at Azim Premji University now, I think part of the year. He was telling me that, do you know the endowment of Azim Premji University, what Azim has given is roughly $2 billion. It's more than the endowment of Brown. This is the way he thinks. He said the way he thinks is really global. He wants to build an institution which will stand out. And that's his way of thinking. Some of the other things I've learned as I have been on the way he does business, how he watches costs. Every time we have a new product, a new car, I always go to him, Azim, buy a car, buy a Lexus, buy this. The first thing is always, it's too expensive. I can't afford it. So Azim will be very comfortable. You can, you know, when you drive up to Kunur, you'll be able to read a newspaper in the back. His question is, can I read a paper in your car when I drive? That's my first thing. First most important criteria for buying a car. So we have to go over all that. Once in a while, I get a call, Vikram, what's the price of an Innova? I said, yeah, so-and-so. What's the discount? Are you buying 100 cars? No, I'm only buying one. The other. So, you learn, the way one grows is not obviously, it's a nature of a businessman, how he controls his money, how he controls his budget. It's not about being flashiness the way he's built himself up. And it's there in every aspect of his work, his personal practices, how he lives his life. I like to cook, and I know Azim likes to eat. And every time I try to have a big dinner, cooking dinner, where I spend the whole day cooking, I invite him and his wife, Yasmin. First thing he asks is Gitanjali there. He says, if you are alone, you're very boring. Only if your wife is there, it's a little fun. So we have to make sure Gitanjali is there and my daughter is there, then he does arrive. And then he eats. But finally, he eats everything. He says it's very good. But I think he still likes that brain masala at KGA more than anything else that I have seen. That's always his favorite food. He mixes around everywhere. He's such a big shot, but you see him everywhere, as simple as everyone else. Thank you very much for the tremendous support you've given my family. And you've given to people all over the country. Once we were coming back from Japan together from a delegation, and at the airport, Azim was tired, I was holding his bag, then we finally got a cart for him, and we went from one side of the airport to the other, and almost everyone was waving out to him. It was quite amazing, the amount of people who knew him in Singapore airport. So I'll conclude just by saying, one of the big things I've learned from him is, talk less and do more. Thank you very much, Azim.
Thank you, Mr. Kirloskar. The MMA Business Leadership Award was instituted in the year 1969. in memory of late Sri S. Anantharamakrishnan, founder and past president of the Madras Management Association, to recognize and acknowledge business leaders who are models of excellent business practices. Up until now, 18 luminaries of the Indian industry have done the award proud by accepting it, every one of them an outstanding leader of global acclaim, an exceptionally active proponent of the social responsibility of business, and a fine individual who, in essence, emulated Sri S. Anantharamakrishnan's business philosophy and beliefs. Instead of my telling you about our 19th awardee, why don't you all place your eyes back on the screen for a snapshot of the man that is Mr. Azim Premji.
Some are born leaders. Some become leaders through their work. Some have leadership thrust upon them. Azim Hasham Premji is all three. Today, the spotlight is on a person for whom business as usual means something very different. His way was to look at it in the spirit of service for the common good. He was born into a business family, so he was destined to be a leader. At 21, he was called back from Stanford University to take over his family's business due to the untimely demise of his father. So he had leadership thrust upon him, and he learnt to lead in a nascent field like technology, which was very new to the world back then.
You know, I was very strongly influenced by my mother's history and track record. She was a medical doctor. She never practiced medicine. At the age of 27, she started and founded the Children's Orthopedic Hospital.
Inspired by Mahatma Gandhi's classic concept of trusteeship, Azim Premji built an enterprise that brought together extraordinary talent and created a business culture which stressed that the path taken was just as important as the destination. It called for complete fair play and justice in all aspects of business. He empowered his people early. In his words, at Wipro, we gave responsibilities early, even when people were, say, only 60% ready to take them on. This helped immensely as the company built, retained, and enriched the talent pool. It also gave rise to a lot of future entrepreneurs who went on to express their individuality by creating great companies in their own vision when they branched out. It was J.R.D. Tata who said, "I don't want India to be an economic superpower. I want India to be a happy country." Azim Premji has straddled both worlds. His Wipro made India a game changer in technology and software, and through his wealth, he has touched millions of lives, spreading happiness. If people don't laugh at your goals, then your goals are too small. Premji said these inspiring words, and this attitude of setting mighty standards was business as usual in his working life, and now in his new increased role as harbinger of change in education and empowerment of India's people. As we celebrate the legacy of Azim Premji today, we celebrate the success of his organization, achieved with integrity and fairness, but most importantly, we celebrate the humanity he brought into every aspect of his life in his long business journey.
Ladies and gentlemen, I now invite Mr. A. Krishnamurthy, Chairman of the Amalgamations Group, to address the gathering and read the citation and also present the 19th MMA Amalgamations Business Leadership Award 2019 to Mr. Azim Premji, Chairman Wipro Limited. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. A. Krishnamurthy.
Mr. Azim Premji, Mr. Wagul, Mr. Murugappan, Mr. Karlaskar, Mallika Srinivasan, Ram Bangatramane, Mr. Vijay Kumar, distinguished invitees, ladies and gentlemen. I am happy to be with you all on this very memorable occasion. Very few leave an indelible impress on the canvas of the nation, and these few people have a far-sighted vision. One such person was my father and founder of Amalgamations Group, Sri S. Sanatana Ramakrishnan. The will to weather the challenges and the spirit to seize new opportunities have sprung from foundations of values and the philosophy of commitment to business ethics and social responsibility he cherished and shared with the distinguished recipients of the award. Madras Management Association, which he co-founded in 1956, is a classic example of his passion for promoting excellence in business practices and education. The Business Leadership Award for this year is being presented to Mr. Asim Premji. By his presence today in our midst in Chennai, Mr. Premji has brought an air of inspiration to the business community and an air of everlasting lessons to all the youngsters and the student community. It is indeed my proud privilege and honor to present to you the citation of Mr. Asim Premji. Does success come from extraordinary things? Not really. The three ordinary things which I believe are the drivers of success are hard work, perseverance, and honesty, says Mr. C. Premji, the iconic business leader and philanthropist the world respects and admires. In the year 1966, at the age of 21, and on the untimely demise of his father, Mr. Premji had to interrupt his stream of dreams, cut short his Stanford education, and return to India to take over the reins of the family business that produced edible oil. Mr. Premji diversified into consumer products and hydraulic cylinders and renamed the company Vipro. Mr. Premji built a reputation for engaging the best and providing them with unparalleled training and freedom. Drawing inspiration from his father for building a business with impeccable integrity and his mother for philanthropy, Mr. Premji created a trailblazing success story of transforming their $2 million edible oil business into an $8.5 billion global IT powerhouse with a presence in 58 countries, alongside a $2 billion business that spans consumer durables, precision engineering, and healthcare products. The efforts Mr. Premji put in to achieve this was an amalgamation of hard work and ethical, fair, and ecologically sustainable business practices with customer as the focus. Mr. Premji steered Wipro to be a global leader in sustainability and cutting-edge technology, blending with it a humane approach. The greatest legacy Mr. Premji has passed on to the corporate world is a nation building through business leadership and philanthropy. Wipro was always quick to sense the opportunities and entered the IT space manufacturing hardware in the early 80s and later forayed into software and experimental successfully with OT offshore services. Mr. Premji created a culture of striving for excellence in business operations. Wipro contributed in no small measure to India getting a head start over other nations and achieving a colossal status as a software exporting nation. Mr. Premji pursued his unfinished dream 3 decades later and at 54 completed his degree in electrical engineering from Stanford University. Despite being one of the most successful corporate leaders in India, Mr. Premji is recognized for his modesty and simple lifestyle, believes that a fully educated child is a strong national asset as a citizen, and in the year 2001, he established the non-profit Mrs. Asim Premji Foundation with the vision of contributing towards a just, equitable, humane and sustainable society. Today, the foundation's work spans across education and other critical fields of human development, with operations across 7 states of India, and has a rapidly scaling initiative to support other not-for-profit entities through financial grants. Mr. Premji's donations to the endowment of the foundation of over $21 billion makes it one of the largest foundations in the world. Mr. Premji has received numerous honors and accolades. He was conferred in the year 2011 with Padma Vibhushan, the second highest civilian award in India. Leading business newspapers and magazines have named him as one of the most influential people in the world. Mr. Premji is the first Indian recipient of the Faraday Medal and has been conferred honorary doctorates in many institutions in India and abroad. The Republic of France bestowed upon him the Legion of Honor. With so many strings to his bow, Mr. Premji relinquished his executive responsibilities at Wipro Limited in July 2019 to focus on philanthropy. A true gem of Mother India, Mr. Premji is a glittering icon symbolizing the triumph of professional and ethical entrepreneurship. In redefining the contours of philanthropy, Mr. Premji has set an example not just in India, but across the world. We, the President and members of the Madras Management Association and Amalgamations Group, have great pride in honoring Mr. Asif Premji, Chairman Wipro Group, with the MMA Amalgamations Business Leadership Award 2019 on this 21st day of November 2019. Signed, A. Venkatramane and Krishnamurthy for Amalgamations Group. Thank you.
Thank you.
It is now time, ladies and gentlemen, to hear from the man of the moment himself. It is with immense pleasure that I now request Mr. Azim Premji to take the podium and speak a few words of acceptance and deliver the 19th Anantharamakrishnan Memorial Lecture.
You know, I'm totally overwhelmed with the compliments which have been paid to me. And, you know, I've almost come to a stage of believing in them. I hope I don't lose one of my strengths, which is my humility. And as Churchill said, I have much to be humble about. Honorable people on the dais, ladies and gentlemen, and friends and customers, thank you. I would like to really appreciate the honor which has been done to me by giving to me this award. I know your association is probably the most prestigious management association in the country, and the track record of winning the number one position has borne it out. So I'm particularly humbled by being given this award and particularly humbled by accepting this award. Let me share a few thoughts with you on this occasion. The success of Wipro is not my success. The success of Wipro is the success of many, many people in leadership, in levels below leadership, who have really devoted their lives and their commitments to making a success of Wipro. And the same thing applies to our foundation, where the kind of devotion, sacrifices people make, compensation sacrifices people make in the service of our people is something which is really outstanding and, you know, is far beyond the compliments which you people have paid me today. It was my mother and Mahatma Gandhi who most strongly influenced my thinking and actions on what I should have, what I should do with the privilege of my wealth. My mother was one of the founders, the prime founder of the Children's Orthopedic Hospital in Bombay, which was the first hospital of its kind for polio children and cerebral palsy children in Asia. She did it at the age of 27. She was a doctor, she never practiced medicine. And she was the chairperson of this hospital up to the age of 78. She really gave her life to it, and she built an organization which really stood out in terms of social service. The Mahatma Gandhi's idea that wealth must be for the people and there must be a trusteeship to it is something which I have believed in very strongly. There is just so much a family or an individual can consume. And ultimately, if people are very wealthy, they have to have a certain trusteeship for that wealth and use it for the public good. That is very, very important. And I would endear everyone here with massive wealths to be willing to devote a part of that, a substantial part of that, for the public good. The more I get involved, and I've been particularly more involved in philanthropy in the past 1 year, the more I realize how much more complex doing philanthropy initiatives is as compared to running a business. Issues are much more subtle, convictions are much more difficult to drive home, and the incentivization which you give people is not in money. It is in recognition, it is in the challenge and in the appreciation for the work which they are doing for social service. Our success in business has taught us many things, but on social issues, we have to all start afresh. We have to be prepared for the processes of consensus, development, discovering of a large complexity in execution, and deeply conflicting but equally valid demands, very often not even knowing the next step forward. We do learn and we will contribute, but we need much more patience and humility than in business. Third, we have to trust the common people of the country. Let me take an example. In my 20 years of work in education, I have realized that teachers who are often blamed in the government sector for being callous, for not caring for their jobs, for being derelictions of duties, are the most committed people I have come across. You know, like in any industrial distribution, 20% of the people are people we should not be having. That happens in a company, that happens in the teachers. But 80% of the teachers in our experience are devoted, and 20% of them are outstanding. They put in much more work than we find our people put in our own company. And we are reasonably competitive as a company. You know, we have workshops for them which take place on a Sunday. They come for these workshops at their own cost and are there on a Sunday, 4 hours, 5 hours, once a month. It is impossible for us in Wipro to get people to come for training on a Sunday or a Saturday. And that's a reality. People expect to be having training on a Monday through a Friday. And it's these teachers who everyone mudslings at, who are willing to do this. Why? They're doing it because they want to do their job better. They're doing it because they want to teach the children better. And they're doing it not for the sake of expecting any promotions for it, because promotions don't take place in government. Real changes take place when the front line changes. And for that to be effective, one has to empower people. I think that's absolutely fundamental to change, empower people. And then you'll see change which lasts and which is really integrated to the system. This is the 150th year of the birth of Mahatma Gandhi. There is still much to learn from him for all of us. In addition to the idea of trusteeship, I think we can learn a lot more from the life of the Mahatma. This may be particularly relevant to all of us who are leaders in our own right. Let us take just one aspect, which I will call moral leadership. How is it that one man could sway and influence hundreds of millions of people to action while holding no formalized power position? Part of this answer lies in the Mahatma's moral leadership, which millions followed, not requiring any power to sway them. The moral leadership was the result of three interlinked aspects of his behavior. First was his relentless and uncompromising pursuit of the truth, however difficult, however challenging, and however threatening it could be, personally threatening. Discovering new aspects of truth that challenged his previous beliefs, he was ever ready to change and modify his stand and accept that he had been wrong in a certain viewpoint. It takes a rare amount of courage for a man in his position to accept that he has been wrong. Second was the importance he gave to means over ends. We have witnessed this again and again in his life, and even the most cherished most cherished time of independence for our country could not justify the means that were at odds with the unshakable belief in nonviolence. His actions always made crystal clear the importance of ethics, of weighing means over ends, and of doing the right thing always. Third was his quite simply his innate empathy and humaneness. His devotion to the weak and poor is too well known to bear any repetition. His efforts to unite India, cutting across every caste, every creed, was possible best because of this strong conviction which he carried throughout his life. But even more telling was his ability and commitment to see and draw from the best of even his adversaries. At the core of this was his empathy towards all, not only towards his fellow human beings, but also towards animals, towards nature, and all that animated from the universal life of force. With this timely pursuit of truth, the importance of means over ends, and the empathy for all living matters embodied in his person and lived every day in the public eye, he did not seek power over people, but it was this that gave him the moral leadership over the people. The people recognized in him a beacon, an ideal, a leader who were inspired to follow. Those of us who had the privilege to be in leadership roles will realize that the power of position diminishes with time, whereas moral leadership endures indefinitely. I truly believe that all of us have a duty to contribute to society. Practice of moral leadership will help us in this, as it will also help us in business. We need to work together to develop the India that we have envisioned in our constitution, an idea that is equitable, humane, and sustainable. I thank you again for giving this honor of bestowing this award on me. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your very incisive views and thoughts which you shared with us and for just being you. Ladies and gentlemen, we are also extremely grateful to our distinguished dignitaries, Mr. Vagal, Mr. M.M. Murugappan, and Mr. Kirloskar, for offering their felicitations on this momentous occasion. We're also indebted to the BLA Selection Committee, comprising of Mr. Ratan Tata, Chairman Emeritus, Tata Sons Limited, Ms. Arundhati Bhattacharya, former Chairman, State Bank of India, Mr. R. Seshasai, Vice Chairman, Hinduja Group, Mr. M. M. Murugappan, Executive Chairman, Murugappa Group, and Mr. Sunil Kant Munjal, Chairman, The Hero Enterprise. We are fortunate that Mr. Murugappan was able to represent the committee today, as the others were unfortunately unable to make it due to prior engagements. We would now like to thank our dignitaries for taking the time out to be here with us on this special occasion. May I request Mr. A. Krishnamurthy, Chairman of the Amalgamations Group, to present a little something to remember the occasion by, a memento to first Mr. Vagal. Next to Mr. M.M. Murugappan. And now to Mr. Kirloskar. Thank you, sir. Thank you, gentlemen, once again for taking the time out to be here with us. Thank you, sir. Deloitte, our consultant for the award, has put together an excellent process for selecting the awardee, which made the job of the distinguished selection panel much, much easier. May I now request Ms. Mallika Srinivasan to please step forward and present a memento as a token of our appreciation to Mr. Kumar Kandaswamy, partner Deloitte, and Mr. P.S. Iswaran, partner Deloitte. Excuse me. And now to deliver the formal vote of thanks, I'm going to call upon Group Captain R. Vijay Kumar, retired VSM Executive Director, Madras Management Association, recipient of the Vishisht Seva Medal from the President of India, under whose dynamic leadership MMA has been selected the AIMA's Best Management Association in India for 10 years in a row from 2008 to 18. I give you Group Captain R. Vijay Kumar, Executive Director, MMA. Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's indeed a proud moment and great honor for me to be here to deliver the formal vote of thanks. And this is the third occasion of Amalgamation Leadership Award, which I am blessed to associate, first being the Sunil Bharati Mittal, then Mr. Ratan Tata, today the great Azim Premji. There are so many people who made this award function a grand success. First, Mr. Azim Premji, for so kindly accepting the award today, and did the honor to for the award being there, and also delivered the Anantharaman Memorial Lecture. A thought-provoking address today kindled the thought process of many. I'm quite sure many of you today who are present here, your takeaway will be such that we are going to continue to contribute to the society, which needs a lot of contribution to people like you who are here today. Thank you so much, sir. Your presence really added tremendous honor to us today. Mr. Vogel, former chairman of ICICI Bank, when we requested him, he readily agreed. And Vogel is a well-wisher. He was associated with the award for so many years. He knows the award very well. And his presence added tremendous value for being there, because we all look up to him with reverence, because other day, last week when I spoke to him, he mentioned that he goes to Kriya University to attend regular classes even today. That shows you have to be a lifelong learner, and your presence and your delivering the felicitation today is a great honor to us, sir. Thank you so much. Mr. M.M. Murugappan, well-wisher of MMA, always there for MMA to help us, and we request him to join the jury. He joined us, and today also he joined the offer the felicitation in spite of his commitment to travel out of station. And his presence as a jury had a tremendous value, because he set the right tone and also made the process very easy. Mr. Murugappan, thank you so much for your presence today. We are indeed grateful to you. Mr. Vikram Kirloskar, President of CII and Chairman of MD Kirloskar System, come all the way from Bangalore to be with us this evening and offer his felicitation. That also added tremendous value for us, and we look forward to seeing you more in MMA, sir. We are going to invite you for major events, which I am quite sure are going to come to us. Thank you so much for your presence. Mr. Krishnamurthy, Chairman, who has been a great source of inspiration for us, always guided us when we go to him about the proposal and getting the process done. He's one person who said process driven, what should be done, and always his humility and make us do the work was so easy, and that made the award process so simpler and so nice. And Mr. Krishnamurthy, you are a source of great inspiration for us, and thank you so much for being a source of guide to us, sir. Our next person, Mr. Mallika Srinivasan, what to say about her? She's one of the one who is always behind MMA for everything. She's the one who drives us to do it. In fact, I can say she's Adeline who pumps us to do whatever we are doing, because she's one person whom we always look up to, a reverence, perfectionist, and if the event is not going to happen this way, I think it doesn't happen. Thank you, madam. You have been a great source of inspiration. Your guidance really made us do all that. And panel of jury, very high profile panel, Chairman Ratan Tata, other you all heard before, Cheshai, Munjal, Mr. M.M. Murugappan, and former Chairman of State Bank of Arundhati. Such a high profile jury to get the whole process done. It went like meticulously because the jury had been so magnanimous to allot the time to be go through the process, and because and also select the awardee today. They are also feel privileged to select the awardee today, and we are indeed thankful to the distinguished jury and Deloitte, both Mr. Kumar and Ishwaran. Without your thing, we wouldn't have put the process the way as efficient as it should be done. And I know a team of 15 professionals worked so hard for a period to shortlist a candidate, analyze them, and put to the jury. It made the jury soft, so simple. Thank you, Kumar and Ishwaran, for your support. Team MMA and team TAFE and Team Amalgamation Group, they have been a great source of support to us, especially Team TAFE, Sunita and his team from there, Balaji, and also from Amalgamation Group, Mr. Ramachandran and Jay Kumar, who have been always with us whenever we wanted something. There's no hesitation to support us. Thank you, big thank you. You made this event a grand event and success. My team from MMA Secretariat, they have been working for the last 6 months tirelessly to make this event a grand success. And big thank to my team. I think without them, I don't think we would have achieved all the accolades what I'm getting. They are the people responsible for it. I can tell you, Team MMA, you are the best. Then Show Space for putting this event together and creating this place so beautiful, befitting the occasion. Thank you, Show Space. And most importantly, the past presidents and members of MMA Managing Committee, without whose support, I don't think we would have traveled so far what we have been achieved. And each one of them have been a source of guidance and inspiration for us. And they are the one who drives us to do as many events as possible and live up to the vision of MMA to be the fountain of world-class excellence. And members of the media who turned up in big number, I'm quite sure without your support, I don't think many of the events would be a grand success. Thank you for your presence and Hotel Taj for the great arrangement. And last but not the least, my members of MMA and the invitees who have come in such a big number. You are the one who make this award a grand success. I think it's a great tribute and thanks to each one of you. And last but not the least, the gentleman who received the award made the MMA Amalgamation Award a grand thing. I think I request you all to please stand, give a standing ovation, gentlemen, because it richly deserves what you think. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen.
Ladies and gentlemen, all good things must come to an end, and so must today. This brings us to the end of the special award function for the MMA Amalgamations Business Leadership Award 2019. We'd like to thank you all for being here with us on this special occasion. I began this evening asking you to remain seated. This time I'm going to complete by requesting you all to please rise for the national anthem. Thank you very much to all of you. And another big round of applause, I think, is owed to Mr. Premji for all he does. Congratulations once again, sir. Thank you.